Sure. I don't have anything big planned. Just a giant blowout party with all the Barbies with that choreography and the spokes on. You just got me.
So cool.
Yeah.
It's Sunday morning on CBS. And here again is Mo Rocca.
That's two-time Oscar nominee Margot Robbie as the iconic doll Barbie. You might say that, like Barbie, Robbie herself is adaptable to pretty much any role, and much more than just a pretty face. Tracy Smith has one of our Sunday best.
What's it like walking around here now?
I love it. I just love to, I remember when shooting up there. I remember I did all my dance lessons around there. It was so surreal.
Actor-producer Margot Robbie says a studio lot is one of her favorite places on Earth.
It's so exciting. There is nowhere more magical, nowhere more fun than a set.
And she should know.
Here we go. Barbie Day 1.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Dad. Her latest film, Barbie, is a star-studded summer spectacular that's being hailed as the film to see. If you love Barbie or hate her. This Barbie has all the accessories, the retro dream house, the pink car, and of course, Ken, played to the hilt by Ryan Gosling.
How do I stay over tonight?
Why?
Because you want to go with my boyfriend.
To do what?
I'm actually not sure.
Just looking at Margot Robbie, you might not think the role was much of a stretch, but it's never easy to play a legend, either living, dead, or plastic.
What do I have to do?
You have to go to the real world. You can go back to your regular life, or you can know the truth about the universe. The choice is now yours.
The first one, the high heel.
You have to want to know, okay? Do it again.
It seems like you're all about taking risks.
Yeah.
I like taking risks. I love what I say. I'm a thrill seeker. It doesn't scare the out of me. I know that I'm really good for it.
Close your eyes.
And in Barbie, Robbie's sometimes in risky territory, especially for a tour.
You guys ever think about dying?
Her character and her look is about a million miles from her previous role in last year's Babylon, where she played a young actress with boundless talent, like the ability to cry her heart out on command.
Yes.
Talk about this crying IQ thing. You can really do that.
Yes. I did 300 and something episodes on the soap, so I have a fair share of practice crying IQ.
How?
I don't know. I think it's like a muscle. I can say to a director, do you want it on my left eye or right eye?
Stop.
And tell me the word you want it to drop.
And what is going through your head? Like, where does it come from?
I don't know. Just, honestly, it sounds so stupid and derivative, but I just think of something sad.
But in her life, she says, there's really not much to be sad about. Margot Robbie was raised by a single mom in Queensland, Australia. Through sheer persistence, she hit pay dirt at age 17 with a role on the popular Aussie soap, Neighbours. Cue the tears.
Can you promise me?
She was a perfect fit for the show. Almost.
I have a very strong Two Australian for neighbors. They had a dialect coach come in to make me sound less Australian for the most Australian TV show.
What is, can you do it? What's a two Australian accent?
It's very like, oh, how's it going? Like, just not nice on the ear. And they tried to round it out. So nasal, you need to just round that out.
So ask yourselves, why would Pan Am, the best airline in the world, promote someone so young?
But her American accent was good enough to land her a series here. Pan Am in 2011. It only lasted one season, so she started sending out audition tapes, including a Hail Mary pass to a casting agent for a new Martin Scorsese film, The Wolf of Wall Street.
No part of me considered that I would ever, my tape would ever be seen by Martin Scorsese.
And she was as surprised as anyone when she got a bite.
But when they first told you, oh yeah, Marty wants to see you, your reaction was? I was so confused. I didn't know who Marty was, to be honest. I was like, they said Marty wants to see me. I was like,
Who's Marty? So Martin Scorsese, and I was like, how does he know who I am? They're like, he watched your tape, and I was like,
Martin Scorsese watched my audition tape?
And they're like, yeah, he wants you to come in and read with Leo, and I was like, Leo, as in Leonardo DiCaprio.
We're nickname basis already with everyone. Yeah, it was wild.
We're gonna be friends.
Yeah. My friend?
Her performance opened a lot of eyes and a lot of doors. Since then, she's played everything from the Queen of England.
Count. Cover. Confidence.
To a complete psychopath.
Seriously, the hell won't you people?
For bad guys, it's what we do. And she went from breaking glass windows to glass ceilings. In 2014, she started her own production company to make female-focused films like this one. For the movie I, Tonya, Robbie actually learned to skate like an Olympic figure skater and to fight like, well, Tonya Harding.
I outskated him today.
We also judge on presentation. Her turn as Tonya got her the first of two Oscar nods, but also put her on the map as a producer, drawing comparisons to Katharine Hepburn, who used her own business sense to help bring the Philadelphia story to the screen.
I'm such an unholy mess of a girl.
What do you think of that comparison? I mean, there could be no high praise for me because I adore Katharine Hepburn. But yes, I think I definitely have that kind of, I've always been like a bit of a, like, yeah, I've had a business savvy brain.
And Robbie's success has allowed her to do things even more important to her in movies.
When you got your first paycheck, you had kept a written record of all the money that you borrowed from your mom.
God, you do your research.
Yeah. Yeah, I have that piece of paper still. I kept it. Yeah, everything I owed my mom, I had it written down. She'd take money out of like the house mortgage, lend me money. So I always knew, I was like, I've got to pay that back. And then one day when I made enough money, I just paid that whole mortgage off completely. I was like, Mom, don't even worry about that mortgage anymore. It doesn't even exist anymore.
You paid off her house.
Yeah.
But actually, awesome. Honestly, anyone in my position, you'd do that for your mom. Of course you would.
Margot!
Of course, she's made her mom proud in other ways. Last year, the British Film Academy celebrated her lifetime in film. Never mind that she's only 33.
Does it feel kind of weird to get that at such a fairly young age?
Yeah,
I felt like, I don't think I should be getting this. Like, I'm too young to be getting anything that has the word lifetime in it. But I'll take it, thanks.
And with her latest role, it's clear that she's earned her own place in Hollywood history.
I know I'm hardworking and blah, 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 but I'm also the luckiest. Yeah, person in the world. You know, every time that I did something, I was like, oh, now it's the top. It will never get better than this. And then somehow it's just kept getting better and better. I'm so, so grateful and lucky.
I'm the master reptile.